Hello everyone, this is Builder Shed here, and today we're going to be reviewing Plasma. Sorry for not uploading at all this week or till today, because I got a little surprise for you. Yup, I switched to Gen 2. I'm going to be doing a new thing, like, where basically every month I try a new distro, like, as a daily driver. As you can already see through LSBLK, I chose to set up another home, like a separate home partition, so I don't have to use what will now be my Xbox One hard drive. But other than that, yeah. So I'm on Gen 2, of course. I had to do a bunch of things, so there were some obvious things. But now I can get to recording and stuff. But let's get to the point. This is KDE Plasma out of the box. Well, almost. Of course, I made some changes. I had some icons down here, and I'm not a big fan of the Breeze mouse, but I am a fan of the other parts of Breeze, but not the cursors. But again, I did change it back to the cursor in the settings, but wouldn't take full effect till after restart. But I'll change it back to my normal favorite Edwatic cursor. So let's get into it. So, KDE is one of the big, not sure if you'd say four or five desktop environments, which I would probably say are GNOME, KDE, Cinnamon, Mate, and XFCE. Those are what I consider the big five. GNOME, KDE, just like Cinnamon, are great for people like who just want to stick to a more like traditional layout that they use if they come from Windows. Like, your super key obviously opens up this, and you obviously, like, as you can obviously see, like, yeah, like, we got that. But the big positive here is overall customization. KDE is a really good looking desktop environment, but you can do a lot of customization with KDE. Seriously though, people call this one of the most customizable desktop environments out there for a reason. I liked it. There's a reason why I like XFCE and KDE for like customization wise. It's because they're very customizable. I wish I could downgrade to GNOME 3.38 though, so I can go back to using Dash the panel, dash the dog and stuff, because for some reason those two haven't upgraded to GNOME 4 yet. But let's continue. So if throw off a customization, you'd open up into system settings, you can go to global theme. This is more your advanced area. But before we get in there, let's hurry up and go to folder settings. So here you get a bunch of wallpapers. I, of course, added my own wallpapers, obviously. I'm not a big fan of the current wallpaper that's being used. It looks good, but I'm going to choose one that I've already installed. Or screw it, I may choose one of my Minecraft wallpapers, which I always go through. So, what looks the best? Bill Shed color scheme right there. Let's get it going. Yep. Now let's exit out of there. So here is it right here. Of course, you can add desktop icons if you want. Oh boy, I may just screw something up. Oh boy. Okay, we're good. So next, oh my, That's another thing. KDE can be a little slow for some reason. I don't know why, but so now here's like you're more like going to further around here. The nice thing, so basically you have some default ones, breeze, like the two breeze ones, and oxygen air. Of course, I added some in. In fact, nice thing is you literally got something where you can just get a bunch of themes and styles and stuff for plasma just through this. Not everything's gonna download properly, but you're gonna get, but they'll some like a lot of things will download partially, but that still means you can use part of the theme. I'm not waiting 10 hours for that to load up. So we're just choose from there. Now you got the other ones. For example, you got MS Windows 9X if you want to just more classic theme, like old school, old Gen X or millennial type thing, if you know what I mean. Yep. Now that's taking 10 hours for some reason. Okay, now it's loaded. I'm gonna go back to Breeze because that's my favorite out of all these. Let's try configure GNOME/GTK application style. Let's see what we can do here. Install from file. Let's see where I can find these. Come on, where's the Jeopardy theme? Okay. Okay, let's go into. My dot files, yup. Themes. Let's choose one that I like the most. White Sir Dark. Welcome to the club. I don't know what's going on here. Let's go back into themes. Come on, Shed, you're not blind. Thinking what's a specific file, but that's nothing to really go full on serious about. You want applications to, oh wait, yeah, we've already been in that area. Now this area, well, we might pick out all these. Oh yeah, that one's gonna be pretty good. Here it goes black. Now I got a bunch of icons to choose from. I'm gonna go the reversal black because like I don't like reversal black. It's a good one. So let's click apply. Now I got those good looking icons. Cursors. Boy, let's get a new cursor when this thing stops trying to take 10 hours. Here, back that. And you can change many others in here. I'm going to go with Vortex Plasma, which didn't seem to even do much. Well, I did put some down here. So you can do a lot more customization wise. So here's the other part of customization. First of all, of course, you can change his icon on, like, in Windows. If you're on Windows, you're going to have to install, I believe, Classic Shell to change your icon. Or Nana is OpenShell. I should get all peeps in VM at some point, but... Yep, so... Let me go to Configure Application Launcher. Icon. Choose Icon. First thing wants to take 10 hours again. Oh my. Having to take a long dang time, right? How long has this been going? Oh my. 12 minutes, not that bad actually. So of course you can choose a Windows one if you're that much of a, dare I say, clown. Of course wants to take 10 years again. Okay, you can hurry up now. Let's search for Gen 2. So now I got a little Gen 2 icon right there. If that will work, if that wants to replace. Yep. Got a good Gen 2 icon right now. I think it wants to take 10 years again. So if we got a separate Gen 2 icon, like another one, other than that one down there, I'd say that doesn't look bad. Pretty bad setting of use flags. Who knows? Well, as long as Plasma still works, we're good. I'm just gonna cut to when this is done. Okay, just checked and it's not there, so let's cancel and stop wasting our viewers' times. Cause y'all don't need to be treated like trash. You wash this stuff. Like, y'all ain't bad people, hopefully. So, now we got this thing. Let's move it to the center. Well, not as customizable in that sense as I thought, but hey, yeah. So we can shrink the panel, as it's called. It'd be a bit smaller. We can configure it. I can get it to be smaller. We can add widgets. So we can move this up and down if we want. Oh boy. So we can make. So, for example, let's move it up here and create a little dock. Oh boy, I messed the dock up. Oh boy. Move it up there. You should always be right there. Like this is. So I guess we got a little dock here. Configure it. Try to get everything centered. Keyboard, no. Appearance. What this does. Yeah, I don't know why it's slow right now. I think there are plenty of dock applications to get for this too. Now we got this tire situation. I'm gonna go finish adding this panel. Oh my. Yeah, I don't know what's going on here. Let's go to more options, see what we can change even more. Center everything. Or there could be a possibility, it could be OBS. Did I accidentally pull out the wrong one? Nope. The right one. guess I'll have to go panel nuking. Okay, let's add a default panel. Where the heck did it go? Here comes the panel. Let's remove those. Okay, that's basically my setup for KDE Plasma now. So, yep. As said, desktop's quite customizable. Though a negative that you need to realize is that this desktop can be quite slow. I'm running an RX 590, and I don't know why this thing takes forever to load programs or freezes in the middle of nowhere. So, I don't know. It could be use flags and stuff, being completely honest here. But this is a good and a really good looking desktop environment. Highly customizable. If you want, and if you're on a lower end device and want a good equivalent, I'd su suggest XFCE. That desktop environment is also really customizable, and I like that desktop environment a lot because of that. So, this is Builder Shed here. Oh, whoa, wait, we forgot to go with the rating. So, this desktop environment, like I said, is a bit slow, but it's also very customizable and looks really good. If I'm gonna give this desktop environment anything, if you weren't counting the cursor here, with like it'd probably be a 4 out of 5, but even counting in the cursor is still a 4 out of 5. It's really good looking desktop environment though it will come with a lot of bloat crap. If you don't like bloat, then well, you might as well go for a lighter end package, but those can always have issues. So just go for whatever. But actually, go on a wiki or something. Go on the Gentoo wiki. Go on the Arch wiki. Go on the Ubuntu wiki. Whatever wiki you use for your distro. Other than that, so the distro. No. Yeah, the desktop environment KDE gets an 8 out of 10 from me. That's a 'cause 4 times 2 is 8, 5 times 2 is 10, obviously. Learn your math tables, kiddos. So, yep. This is Builder Shed. Hope to see y'all next time. See ya! If you like this type of content, make sure to drop a like. If you wanted to see more of this content, make sure to subscribe. If you don't like this content, or specifically this video, drop a dislike. And it'd be heavily appreciated if you were to also drop a comment explaining why you disliked the video and some issues, also known as constructive feedback. I'll see y'all next time. See ya.